Think of a huge natural ecosystem with incredible biodiversity being gradually replaced by a new one where endemic species can't live anymore. That's the reason I wanted to visit the Borneo rainforest, where orangutan and other unique species are seeing their home taken away. I arrived in Kota Kinabalu, in the Malaysian part of the island, and looked for the best way to get to the heart of the forest. On the internet, I ran into Sticky Rice, a tour operator that works closely with the Denon Valley Field Center, a facility for conducting research and supporting scientists in rainforest studies. They helped me arrange my trip. On the way there, I make a detour in Sepilog to visit some centers that take care of endangered species such as orangutan, proboscis monkeys, and sun bears. At the Orangutan Rehabilitation Center, I'm only able to see some young specimens at the outdoor nursery, where orphans are trained to live in the wild. The proboscis monkeys are way easier to approach. In the sanctuary that the palm oil company has kept for them, they are used to walk around visitors. Some silver monkeys are also there. We are really tired of all these tourists walking around and decide to take a nap. Another threatened species endemic of Borneo is the sun bear, a small animal victim of its cuteness. In some Asian countries, they are captured and kept as pets. After taking a bus to Laadatu, I meet the guy from Sticky Rice and hope to Denon Valley. Once there, the adventure starts. Every day, my guide Mac and I take long walks in the forest to spot some wildlife. Really soon, I remember why it's called rainforest. It rains a lot, when you least expect it. And when it rains, it's really hard to move around. The soil is muddy, leeches come out from every plant, and you have to avoid the bites of ants and falling branches. We are able to spot some red-leaf monkey and some macaque, but we are not lucky enough to see orangutans. A group of elephants crossed the river and the forest a week ago, and most of wildlife got scared and ran away.
Borneo rainforest is home to hundreds of species that are endemic and unique of this place. So if this environment disappeared, all these species would be gone and lost forever.
The most mystical experience you can have here is probably hearing the sounds of the rainforest during the night and early in the morning. It is surreal. If you're lucky enough, you can see some small nocturnal animals like civets, mouse deers, western tarsiers. The second best thing here is probably going up the mountain and look at the sunrise slowly waking up the misty forest. It is beautiful. I leave keeping this image in my mind and hoping that in the future humankind will be responsible enough to preserve these spectacular forms of life on our planet. If places like Denon Valley bode well for the future, in other spots in Indonesia, it is becoming more and more urgent to regulate the expansion of palm oil plantation to stop the extinction of endemic species. We as humans should lean back for a second and realize that there are more vital things than money, and most importantly, that this planet doesn't belong all to us.